Hello guys, and welcome back to our macroeconomics session. Now yesterday we saw the foreign exchange rates and what are the types of foreign exchange rates, correct? What are the systems through which we determine the foreign exchange rate of an economy? Today I am going to give you a brief idea, or I am going to give you an insight on our foreign exchange practical approach, right? So for example, today if I say $1 is equal to rupees 70. Suppose this is our current exchange rate. But what happens tomorrow if this becomes $1 is equal to rupees 80? Now you know, in this current situation of pandemic, what is happening is every economy is under a financial crunch, right? They are facing many problems economically. So what will happen is, if more rupee you have to exchange for a single dollar, what happens to our economy? Our economy is our home country, right? And the other economy that we denote our foreign exchange in is the foreign economy. So in our home country, what happens that today we are giving 70 rupees, correct, for $1. But tomorrow it may so happen that you have to pay more in order to get the same amount of commodity, right? So if you take this simple example in our real life situation, you will say that the prices have inflated, the prices have increased. So here also the situation is same. Now when you observe this, even though the numerical value is increasing, but you know that the value of our currency is diminishing. So this situation where the exchange rate increases, where you have to pay more in order to get $1, this is called as depreciation of your currency. Here your currency is not appreciated, your currency is depreciated. So this is called as depreciation of your currency, depreciation of Indian rupee, INR, right? But what happens if there are some new innovative technological changes in your country and your country's products suddenly become demanded by all of the world? So what will happen? Your country will have an upper edge. So then the $1 that you want to demand will happen to be available at, suppose, 65 rupees. So what is happening here? That now your INR or your home currency is also having some more value as compared to what it had before. So this is called as the appreciation. This is appreciation of currency, right? Now, to understand all this in very simple terms, when the exchange rate increases, what happens? The foreign market becomes expensive. Right? Because for one unit of US dollar, you were ready to give 70 rupees, and now again it is increasing and now you have to give 80 rupees. Means the US dollar or the foreign currency, or for that matter, the foreign market becomes expensive. So when you say depreciation, you mean that the foreign currency is expensive and your INR becomes cheaper. Let's take one case at a time. So I am saying, when the foreign currency becomes expensive and your home country currency becomes cheaper, what is the implication on foreign trade? Because without considering the foreign trade, you will never be able to consider the foreign exchange fluctuations, right? You will never be able to calculate how much is the input of foreign exchange from abroad. So here, if the foreign currency becomes expensive, are you going to demand more currency? Of course not, because we are the microeconomic students and we know what Professor Alfred Marshall has been saying all this while, that if the prices are high, the demand is definitely going to reduce. So anything that becomes expensive will be demanded less, correct? So you will have less and less attractiveness towards the foreign market. But on the other hand, what happens is your currency has become cheaper, so the foreigners or the foreign investors will be very much interested in your market. So the domestic market becomes more and more attractive, correct? One thing in case of currency that I told you is that the currency becomes cheaper, but the market for home country, that is the domestic market, becomes attractive, whereas the foreign market for us at the same time becomes inattractive, right? So now when the domestic market becomes attractive, what happens? The people will want more and more of your goods. So it is only advisable at that point of time for you to export more. This can be a profit making opportunity. That even if the prices are low comparatively, if the prices are low, but the quantity sold is huge, so the revenue will always be huge, because we know total revenue is price into quantity, correct? So price is nothing but the foreign exchange that you are going to get from the foreign countries into the quantity sold, means the quantity exported in the international market. So whenever our depreciation occurs in an economy, now see, depreciation is not something which is deliberately put in. Koi aake karta nahi hai depreciate aapki currency. It happens through the market forces of demand and supply. Like I told you, if the foreign exchange increases, foreign exchange rate increases, we call it as the foreign exchange price, correct? So if the price of foreign exchange increases from 70 rupees per dollar to 80 rupees per dollar, what is happening is the value of your rupee is decreasing. So that is the depreciation which ultimately happens through market forces, correct? When your currency is cheaper, whatever is cheaper is attractive in the market. So your market suddenly becomes attractive to the foreign investors and they will want to purchase more and more, means this is your opportunity to export more when your currency depreciates, so that when you export more, your demand will be more and ultimately an equilibrium will be achieved, right? Coming back to the next point of appreciation. What is appreciation? It means when the foreign exchange rate or the price of foreign exchange is decreasing, means today if you are spending 70 rupees to gain that $1, and tomorrow if the economic condition of your home country, that is India, improves, or we are becoming technologically advanced, what is going to happen is we are going to have a little more value in the international market, means your currency is now going to become more valuable. It is not cheaper. Now the foreign currency, means the USD in this case, the foreign currency will become cheaper. Now, although it is not much that cheaper, but it is comparatively cheaper. And if it is comparatively cheaper, it gives you more opportunity to invest in the foreign market. Like we have seen that even if in case of durable goods, like you can say in Diwali sale, what happens? They just put 1,000 rupees off and everybody rushes like they are giving it for free, right? This is the elastic demand. Same thing happens. If we see that the imported goods are available at a cheaper price than before, or there is a sale going on, then what is going to happen? People are going to rush and grab that opportunity. So when the foreign currency is cheaper, or the foreign exchange price is what reduced, what is happening? Lower the price, higher is going to be the demand of the currency. So the market of foreign countries is going to become attractive, and hence the exports will be less and the imports will be more, because you will want to bring more and more at lowest price available, right? So whenever you say depreciation, you mean that the value of your currency is cheaper, the foreign market is unattractive, but your market for the foreign is attractive, hence you will want to export more. On the other hand, what happens if you have to exchange less money for that $1, less rupee for that $1? It is called as appreciation, and in case of appreciation, your money becomes more valuable and then the foreign market becomes comparatively cheaper and more attractive. So this is the base for what we are going to learn today. Today we are going to learn the demand of foreign exchange as opposed to the supply of foreign exchange. Now I'll just give you a small heads up that this entire thing of demand and supply can get very confusing over the period of time. So I am going to give you very precise explanation, very brief, very short, up to the point explanation, so that you don't have to go too much into deep and get confused. When I am saying demand of foreign exchange, I mean the outflow. I want the foreign currency to spend. That is my demand. So whenever you talk about demand of foreign exchange, you are talking about the need to outflow. The need to spend is called as the demand of foreign exchange. Now, why will you need to demand the foreign exchange? It's very simple. When you want to demand foreign exchange, is only for spending that foreign exchange, because you as an economy, it will have no value if you keep it in reserves. Absolutely nothing. You will only want to demand more and more foreign exchange if you want to do one most important thing, that is import goods and services, right? Means if you want to purchase a machinery or let's say a software or a technology from the US, what you are going to do? Are you going to pay them in Indian rupees? Of course not. You will have to pay them in US dollars. So until and unless you have US dollar, how are you going to do the outflow? How is the money going to cross the Indian boundaries? So when you want to import certain goods and services, you will want to demand the foreign exchange. If you feel that the foreign market is very attractive and you want to invest there, if you feel that the foreign goods will have more demand in your domestic market and you want those goods, you want to purchase those goods, means import those goods, for that purpose you will have to demand the foreign exchange. Another one is for making investment in abroad. Now, when you hear the word investment, I think you are very clear about the fact that we are not talking about this FDR investment, RD investment, not this investment. We are talking about the FDI and FII. When is the correct time when you will decide whether to put investment in some country's shares or whether to open your branch in some country's market, or when to purchase the assets of certain company in some other country? When is the correct time? The correct time is only after you determine the foreign exchange rate. Like we studied a while before, the appreciation and depreciation, these things are the things that let you take a decision regarding demanding the foreign exchange. So tomorrow if I want to invest in some other country, what is the thing that I'm going to need is the foreign exchange. Means this is one of the another factor that determines your demand for foreign exchange. When I want to invest in a country or in a business of US, then what is the thing that I'm going to need is the US dollars, because they are going to claim their prices in their home currency. Their home currency is US dollars. So if I want to FDI or FII in their business, then what I have to do is pay them the required US dollars. So for that case, I will do is demand the foreign exchange, correct? Next one is very simple. It is the remittances to abroad. For example, there is a person, let's say relative of yours, who lives in foreign country and he is in need of some money. So what you are going to do, if you deposit Indian rupee, is he able to use those Indian rupees? Will he be able to withdraw Indian rupees and use that? No, what he will need is US dollars or whatever the foreign currency is. So you have to pay him the money in regard to the foreign currency only. So for that, you will have to demand the foreign currency which works in that country, correct? So remittances to abroad means they are the transfer payments, of course you know that by now, but then remittances for remitting money, for sending money to abroad, for that also all you need is to demand the foreign exchange. Another important factor is that of speculation. Now, what is speculation? This word is not new to you. To speculate is to guess, to foresee, and to come up with some foreseeing idea. Speculation is to estimate, we can say, anticipate, we can say, means in the future. So this is the very base of our economic transactions. This stock exchanges, all these things work on speculation only. Now, as we are in this pandemic, I think this is, we can take this to mean an opportunity for us to learn economics little better. Of course, it is taking the life out of people, but then also we can learn so much from this pandemic. We know that when this pandemic is over, or even when it is still going on, what is happening is everybody is losing their jobs. Every economy, every country is under so much of crisis that they are laying off people. They are removing people from jobs. They are sending people back to their resident countries. Why is this happening? Because we know that the demand for our currency is becoming low and low. So tomorrow, when we know that the demand is becoming low and low, we can have some provisions. We can make some provisions, or we can make some products which will have market in current situation also. Like the hand sanitizers, or you can say all the health products, the sanitation products. We can produce those products in India so that the hampering of foreign exchange will not hamper our economy's growth and development. Correct? So we are going to take many measures. So when you talk about speculation, it means you are trying to estimate what will happen to the demand of your currency or the demand of other currency. If you know that the demand, or let's say the market of foreign country is going to improve, if you are under the presumption that this happens all of a sudden, you are wrong. Speculation is not one day thing. Everybody keeps on observing the international market, or let's say if now currently we are very much keen in investing somewhere like US, if we want to develop the technology for a certain industrial sector and we want that technology to come in India, what we are going to do? We are going to observe that market, and whenever it hits a particular low, we are going to purchase that technology, correct? If it is for sale, of course. So speculation also works the same way, that when you think that the demand for particular thing is going to increase in our country, or you can say a demand for particular product, it will work good in our country, you will want the prices to drop so that you demand more. Same thing, demand for foreign exchange. You will speculate the fall in foreign exchange in order to demand that foreign exchange. The prices, if the prices are low, your demand will be high. So speculation, the demand will be high when the foreign exchange rate, when the forex rate or the forex price will go down. Okay, let's not dwell too much into this demand and move forward to the supply of foreign exchange. Okay, before moving to the supply of foreign exchange, one thing I would like to tell you, whenever you talk about demand of foreign exchange, the thing that you have to remember is the word outflow. Demand for foreign exchange is the need for foreign exchange in order to use it as an outflow from your country to foreign country. Okay. Now we will talk about the supply of foreign exchange. Now it is just a trial and error method, you know it. Supply of foreign exchange is nothing but inflow. Very simple. When foreign exchange is coming in your country, it means there is a flow of foreign exchange from foreign to your country, which is called as inflow. If demand is outflow, supply is inflow. True nahi to false, false nahi to true, like that. I think you are well aware of this. Everything, your class is very you can say expert in this situation. Supply of foreign exchange means the money that comes into your country as a result of certain transactions, right? What are those transactions? When will the foreign exchange enter into your country? When you will have to send something in exchange. That sending something is nothing but the goods and services, which is known as the export of goods and services. So, first factor is export of goods and services. Like I told you, that in case of depreciation of your Indian currency, Indian rupee, or the home currency, when your currency becomes cheaper, your market becomes attractive. I am not saying that this is a profitable or a ideal situation for any economy, but I am saying you can find good things in something which is unfavorable to you. Even if in the international market, the value of your currency is going down and down, what you can do is export so much that the demand for your products increase. And when the demand for a particular product increase, you will understand in the later part also that the prices ultimately go up. We know, jo cheeze bahut zyada demand mein hoti hai, unki prices ultimately badh hi jati hai, because anything which is demanded more and has a scarcity or shortage will be demanding more and more prices in the future, right? So export of goods and services are one of the factors which determine your supply or inflow of foreign exchange. Another is investment. Now this investment is to abroad or from abroad. If you want inflow, the investment hub should be your country. So investment from abroad means you can say FDI in India. The more supply of foreign exchange in your country, more is the official reserves that you create in your country, which are ultimately going to affect your balance of payment. But investment from abroad is one of the factors of supply of foreign exchange into your country. Next one says remittances. Now you know what are remittances. We saw this in transfer payments also. Now remittances from abroad, the unilateral payment that people employed there sent to their family for the maintenance and regular expenditure is your remittance. So remittances from abroad means, suppose the US dollars are coming into your country, or let's say another foreign currencies are coming into your country. So that is your remittances from abroad, which is a factor of supply of foreign exchange. But now here tell me, if the foreign exchange rate increases, what will happen? Will the supply of this foreign exchange increase or the supply of foreign exchange decrease? Now what did I say? When the prices of foreign exchange increase. Let's take a numerical example so you will understand it better. I said $1 today cost me rupees 80, and I said the price increases, means the same US dollar, I will have to pay rupees 90 for it. So what will happen now? Will the supply of foreign exchange increase or the supply of foreign exchange decrease? So you don't go by any other perception than what we have learned so far, is that when this happens, what you have to do is immediately think, what is happening to your currency? What is happening to the INR? INR is becoming cheaper. And whatever is cheaper has what? More demand. Means the supply of foreign exchange for you is the demand of foreign exchange for some other country. So what is going to happen is, even if the prices are increasing, the supply will increase, the inflow will be more, because your market, the domestic market, will become attractive. Correct? It will become attractive for your foreign investors. We talk about the attractiveness of our domestic country. What will happen is, if the prices and the supply, if you are going to see the relationship between these two things, if the prices of foreign exchange increases, means from 80 you have to pay 90 now, what is going to happen to the supply? The people in the foreign countries are going to want to invest in your country, means the supply is also going to increase, showing us a positive relationship. So whatever demand and supply theories you studied in microeconomics also apply the same way in macroeconomics. The only difference is that we are having a global approach now. The approach that we are using is that of the entire economy and not just a single person or single firm. Okay? So let's take this in simpler terms. So for understanding it in simpler terms, we are going to just see vis-a-vis appreciation and depreciation. This is the current prices, that is $1 is available to us at 80 rupees for an exchange rate. So when you say depreciation, what do you exactly mean? You mean that the value of your Indian rupee is decreasing. Means now you will have to pay more for the same US dollar. So your rate will become $1 is equal to rupees 90. When you have to pay more for the same amount of commodity, you will have to say that the prices are rising. But in this situation, what happens is your market is becoming more and more attractive, means your INR is available at a cheaper rate, and that is why the domestic country or the domestic market, you can say, becomes attractive. Now people will want to invest more and more in your country's market. They will want to demand more and more of your product, and so even if the prices are higher, the supply or the export that your goods have, the export will be more. Okay, because the domestic market is attractive, your market is attractive. As opposed to this, what will happen in case of appreciation? What is this? In case of appreciation, the value of your currency is good. The value of your currency improves in international market. Means now this $1 will be available in less than 80 rupees. You will have to give lesser in order to take the same $1. Means let's say, for example, you will have to pay 70 rupees. But what happens actually in the economy when such situation arises is, now your money is having more value. Means comparatively, the US dollar is becoming cheaper. So here, the INR is becoming expensive. Now the foreign investors will say, now we have to pay a little more. If they have to pay a little more, they are not going to want to invest in your market. Means your market, the domestic market, is no longer of benefit to them. Means where the domestic market is becoming unattractive, but we are not concerned about this. What we are concerned about is, now here the foreign markets for you have become attractive. Means here you can say the foreign markets are attractive. They are also cheaper, and hence they are attractive. Means now what you will do is, you will want to demand more. So prices are down, the demand is more. Correct? So whenever your currency depreciates, take it as a good opportunity to increase your international trade, and then you can supply more. And whenever your currency appreciates, you know that the money value is increasing, but at the same time, the foreign market is becoming what? Cheaper to you. It is attractive to you. It will give you some opportunities to invest in the international market more and more. It is also giving you an opportunity to increase the percentage or the share of FDI and FII in other countries. So then you will demand more of the foreign goods. Correct? When the price is down, demand is high, indicating the same negative relationship. when the price is high, supply is high, indicating the same positive relationship. Okay, so this is the whole idea behind appreciation, depreciation and demand and supply for foreign currency. And based on all this, we will determine the foreign exchange rates in all other similar types, like the flexible exchange rate system, managed floating exchange rate system, or the fixed and flexible exchange rate system. Okay, that will be all for today. I'll leave you here. Thank you.